Hi friends, this is Shekhar Srinivasan, and in this video we will learn how to develop a C# Windows Forms application to convert text to speech. Now let's try to start with the demo. I just opened my visualstudio.net, a new project, a Windows Forms application, text to speech demo app. Now for the visibility purpose, let me increase the font size. Now I try to take a label to provide a prompt for the user to type in the value. So I have a label where the text I just specified as. Enter your message below. I have a text box. Where I try to set some multi-line for this text box. The name for this text box, I say txt message, multiline is true, and scroll bars vertical. Next, I try to take a label to specify the volume. So I would like to allow the user to select a volume in which he wants to listen. To set that, I would like to take the support of a track bar. So I say track bar. The name for the track bar, I say track bar volume. The volume range can be from 0 to 100. So I say minimum is 0, maximum is 100. And I try to provide a small change as 5 and large change as 10. And by default, the volume, I give the value as 80. Next. Whenever a person speaks, there will be also a change in the speed in which a person speaks. So I take a label where I say speed. The speed can be between 1 to 10. So I try to take a track bar. So that we will allow the user to set the speed in which he wants to speak. So the name for the track bar, I just give it as track bar speed. The value for the track bar, since it should be between 0 to 10, so minimum is 0, maximum is 10. Large change, I provide it as 2, and small change is 1. The default value, I give it as 1. Along with this, I would like to provide a functionality for the user to perform the operations. So I say a button, one to say read, pause, continue. I would like to have an option for recording and also an option for close. So the first button, I try to specify read, so I say btn read. The next button, I would like to say pause, so I say btn pause. The next one I would like to provide as continue, so I just say continue. The name for the button, I mention as continue. The next button I would like to provide for record, so I say btn record, record. And finally, an option to close the application, so I say close, I say btn close. Now once we done with this, in order to support text to speech, we need to add a reference. So I say project menu, add reference. I try to search for system.speech. This is the namespace or the reference which we have to add. Now let's try to start with our demo. For the visibility, I increase the font size. I simply say system.speech and system.speech.synthesis. Under the form declarations, I define the variable for the speech synthesizer, which gives you the control for accessing the speech recognition engine. And within the form load, I try to create an object for the speech synthesizer. Now my requirement is whenever the user clicks on read, I would like to listen to this thing. So read button click. I say ss.rate. Track bar speed.value. Sets the speed. ss.volume. I say track bar volume.value, which sets the volume. And then I say ss.speakAsync, where we have to provide the prompt message. So I just specify the text. This is going to convert the text, whatever we just provided, to the speech, and we can listen to that thing. Next, whenever I wanted to pause it, for the pause button click, I simply say ss.pause. If I wanted to continue further, I simply say ss.resume. So that wherever we stopped it, it will resume back. For the record button click, I first create an object for the speech synthesizer locally, and then ss.rate equal to trackbar speed.value, volume equal to trackbar volume.value. I would like to specify a save file dialog so that we can try to provide a file for saving purpose. I try to use a filter, so the file which we are going to save, it will have a default extension as .wav. I set the output to a wav file, so I just specify this. This is going to be the output, and I say ss.speak. So this will be used for synchronously handling the things. Means till it completes the recording, it will not allow you to perform anything. Whereas speak async method, whenever it is speaking simultaneously, we can handle the other things. It works in an asynchronous way. So I just pass on the message to be used. And once it completes the speaking, then I just again set the output to the default audio device. I would like to give a confirmation saying that recording has been done. Recording completed. Text to speech. And whenever the user is going to click on close, the application has to be closed. So I say close button click. I say application.exit. Now let's try to execute this application. Good morning. I provide a name called as Shekhar. So we can just try to observe it. It's trying to convert that particular text to voice, and we can able to listen to that particular voice. Now whenever you have a huge test, you can just try to make that particular text to read it. So I just try to copy the text and I try to paste it. Let's say read. I can just pause it, and when I say continue, it continues the things. Now in case if I wanted to record it, I click on record. Excuse, I forgot one line. So whenever the user is going to click on record, I just have to show the dialog box. Let's see this. Excuse for this. I click on record, it opens a dialog box, and I select the documents. So demo, I click on save, recording has been done. I click on close to close the application. Now when I just try to check out this, you have the demo. If I try to open with my media player, so we can just listen to this particular thing. Hope you are clear with how to convert text to speech with the support of a C# application. You can also see my other video, how to develop a voice recognition application. If you like this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. This encourages me to develop more and more videos. Thank you, yours, Shekhar.